So lorsuvimab is the small molecule drug that we're developing for the treatment of knee osteoarthritis as a disease-modifying drug. So there's an unmet need in osteoarthritis where there have been drugs for controlling the signs and symptoms, even though they've had serious adverse events that limits their use. There really hasn't been a drug that changes the course of the disease. And disease modification in osteoarthritis is you've got to help the patients feel better regarding their pain and improve function, but you also should show structural benefit because that's what the damage is happening in the knee. So lorsuvimab is a one injection that we've developed, and we've studied so far in one injection out to 6 months and 1 year. And we finished one phase one study and two phase two studies, and we're presenting some of the phase two data here at the ACR meeting. And what it's shown is that the one injection given to the patient's more painful knee improves the pain and function out to 6 months and maintained out to 12 months in most of the patients. And also we've shown improvement in joint space width on x-ray as measured by the x-ray at 1 year too, especially in patients who have unilateral osteoarthritis, because this is an injection given into a single knee. And this has led to, and also had very good safety profile so far, where the overall adverse event percentage is no different than placebo. The serious adverse events were very low. Again, none of the serious adverse events were deemed to be related to the drug by the investigators. So this has prompted us to go into phase three pivotal trials. We have started our first pivotal trial, which is a 12-month trial again, similar to our phase two, where the patients will get one injection of 0.07 milligrams of lorsuvimab versus placebo injection. And then we're going to follow these patients over 1 year. Again, the primary outcome is looking at pain and function at 12 weeks and radiographic improvement and the structural inhibition of structural progression at 12 months. We have a second pivotal trial that's going to start the first quarter of next year in 2020, which is a 6-month trial looking at signs and symptoms again at 12 weeks and maintaining the benefit hopefully out to 6 months. We just completed enrollment in our third study where we're looking at two injections. One injection at baseline, one injection at 6 months, and following patients out to 12 months, which will give us idea about the safety of using this drug with multiple injections. In animal studies, we've injected it as frequently as once a month into animals and looking at the toxicology studies, and we haven't seen any issues, but we also want to be able to provide the physicians the comfort that if the patient needs a second injection, it's safe to administer it, and that study will help us answer that question.